Thank you. Let me take a spell and I'll take it all. My children, yes, you are concerned thy body, thy eggs and thy The spirit of praise. And he looks at you and says, I don't care where you've been. See, this is the awesome part. Because man cares where you've been. But God said, I don't care where you've been. And it really doesn't matter how long you've been there. See, David said he brought me out of a hole. And he set my feet upon the rock. Here was David, an adulterer, a murderer. But yet the Bible says that he was a man after God's own heart.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And after all of that, I go back in my mind to the time that God spoke to Samuel. And he said, I want you to fill your horn with oil. Because in the house of Jesse, I have chosen a king. I'm not going to preach the whole message because God's done some things, but there's a few highlights I want to bring out. Samuel took his oil and went to Jesse's house. Oh. But God didn't tell Samuel to go anoint a shepherd boy. He told him, said, go anoint a king. God spoke to me about 3 or 4 months ago. And he said, get out of the shepherd boy mentality. Because I don't anoint shepherd boys, I anoint kings and priests. Oh, I wish somebody would get hope today. He said, I do not anoint shepherd boys. But he said,
time to get out of the
mentality. I don't have to move. But the instant that I get rid of the shepherd boy mentality and realize that I am anointed by God, that's the time I have to lay down this old man and let the king that's inside of us rise up and take our place in the kingdom of God. God's looking for somebody that will stand up and say, I've been in the wilderness long enough. You see, we try hard to use every excuse we can use. See, when God called me, I told him I couldn't because I can't read. I know people look at me and say, you're 55, almost 55, and I could not read. He said, I'm not calling you because of your ability, but he said, I'm calling you because of what I can do through you. Come on, I'm talking to somebody. Listen, you've been on the backside of the desert.